Итак, какие же типы бывают вот этих дорог и колей? Их я выделил три типа. Первое – это обширные поля от однократного проката колесно-транспортных средств.
What are the types of stone roads and ruts? I have identified three of them. The first type is extensive fields from a single passage of wheeled vehicles. Such fields are most widespread in central Anatolia and Cappadocia. As I said in the previous film, researchers didn't generally know about the field of stone ruts in Cappadocia. My partner in the first expedition in 2014, Andrei Kuznetsov, opened it in the last expedition to Turkey. The first field in the Phrygian Valley of central Anatolia we found during the expedition in 2014 quite by accident. These fields are quite extensive. In the Phrygian Valley, a field with ruts is located between the cities of Eskihir in the north and Nepheon in the south. Its length is about 70 km and the width is 10 to 20 km. The second field in Cappadocia lies between the cities of Aksaray in the west, Kayseri in the north, Tamarza in the east and Nigda in the south. Its size is 166 by 100 km. Within these fields there are groups of ruts which as a rule have an area of several square kilometers, less often several dozen square kilometers. Inside the groups, there are also separate clusters of ruts with a length of 100 to a maximum of 800 meters in the Phrygian Valley and up to 5 kilometers in the Cappadocia.
Как правило, это параллельные колеи, пересекающиеся колеи, наезжающие друг на друга колеи. Но все говорит, что это не дороги, это именно однопрокатный проезд.
As a rule, these are parallel ruts, intersecting ruts, colliding ruts. Everything says that these were not roads, but ruts from a single passage of wheeled vehicles. Moreover, the cars travel along not petrified tufts, tufaceous sedimentary rocks. Indeed, in the middle-late Miocene time in central Anatolia and Cappadocia, volcanoes actively erupted. Pyroclastic material accumulated at the bottom of lakes, marshes mixed with mud. Tufaceous sedimentary strata formed. For some reason, at that time a huge number of wheeled vehicles crossed the expanses of central Turkey when the tufaceous sedimentary strata didn't yet dry. Our measurements in the Phrygian Valley and the measurements of Andrei Kuznetsov in Cappadocia showed that the prevalent width of the lower part of the ruts is 22-23 cm, and the distance between the ruts is 150-160 cm. Both are very close to the parameters of modern cars. This we realized when we were driving a Fiat car along these ruts. It fit very well in them and rode along them until the ruts became too deep. That is, some wheeled vehicles drove along the ruts in the middle-late Miocene. These cars were similar to modern cars.
Какие-то транспортные средства, которые были очень похожи, да. После того, как мы изучили эти колеи, появились материалы на сайте, появилось после очень много, достаточно много перепечаток, ряд исследователей из Канады, из Украины.
After we studied these ruts and published the materials on the site of dopotopo.com, there were a lot of reprints. A number of researchers from Canada, Germany, Ukraine and Israel drove through the places of development on the routes opened by us. After this, several summary generalizing works appeared in a well-known archaeological journals, my articles were reprinted and interviews with me were published. As a result, the routes have become much more widely known. If early the fact of existence of the ruts in central Turkey was hushed up, then after our expedition there they began to be discussed at various forums. Perhaps soon the time will come when archaeologists from academic institutions will begin to study this most interesting, mysterious and at the same time completely understandable form of formations. Understandable for the reason that when you walk along these ruts and look at them, there is no doubt that they were left by wheeled vehicles such as modern cars. Indeed, there are two drops of water-like traces of cars that drive on muddy dirt roads after heavy rain. They look exactly the same. In addition to the numerous articles and video materials that appeared after our expedition, these ruts, as I said, were discussed for a long time at various forums. Including the forum dopotopo.com, researchers offered their versions of what kind of wheeled vehicles drove through them.
Многочисленных вот таких видеоматериалов, фильмов, которые последовали после наших вот таких экспедиций, очень долго обсуждались эти колеи на разных форумах, в том числе на форуме dopotopo.com, вот, и на некоторых других. И исследователи предлагали разные версии, какие колесно-транспортные средства ездили по ним, какая была подвеска, зависимая, независимая.
What was the car suspension, dependent or independent? When wheels sank deep into the ground, they left stretches on the side surface. The ground was clearly stretched by a wheel axle. Many interesting conclusions were made, on which I have no time to stop now, as cars of our ancestors looked. This question beyond the official archaeological literature is well developed. I am sure that academic archaeological science has something to take as a basis before they go on the rats. We have just reviewed the first type of rats. The second type is slightly different. It rather belongs not to petrified rats, but to tepified roads. We met such roads in large numbers in Spain. This is the famous stone rat Castellar de Meca. We have just reviewed the first type of rats. The second type is slightly different. It rather belongs not to petrified rats, but to fortified roads. We met such roads in large numbers in Spain. This is the famous stone road Castellar de Meca. These are the stone roads in Jumilla, Bocariente in the Valencia and Murcia regions. It is also the stone roads in Chufut-Calais and Esquikermen on the Crimean Peninsula. In the last expedition in autumn 2016, we also saw such roads in large numbers in central Italy in the area of development of the Etruscan civilization. As the materials sent by different researchers show, there are many similar roads in Sicily, in Sardinia, there are many similar roads in France, there are similar roads in Germany. These are the roads, they have two flat vertical sides in contact with the roadway at 90 degrees. The sides have different heights, a minimum probably 30-40 cm from a road close, a maximum of 2-3 meters, in some places 4-6 meters. The width between the sides is different. For example, in the Crimea it varies from 2-3 meters in different places. In Spain the roads are only 160-170 cm. Inside the roads there are the same prints of wheels or rats, most often in pairs. Sometimes the third track is visible, sometimes they intersect. That is, it is clear since that not one of vehicle was used, but several vehicles. Similarly, dirt roads look like when different cars drive through them.
Всего-навсего 160-170 сантиметров. При этом расстояние между колесами там чуть-чуть отличается от транспортных средств. Да, внутри вот этих вот дорог находятся такие же отпечатки колес, колей, часто по паре, чаще всего по паре, иногда они как-то и там третий идет, иногда они пересекаются, то есть явно видно, что это ездило не какое-то одно транспортное средство, а несколько транспортных средств, то есть так же точно выглядят современные грунтовые дороги, когда по ним едут разные автомобили. Вот.
With overlapping of ruts, one is deeper, another is less deep. These are typical examples of dirt roads that were in Neogen time. The width of the roads between two sides in the Crimea is 2-3 meters, in Castellar de Meca 160-170 cm, that is, they were very narrow roads. In Italy, roads are different. Some roads are about 2-3 meters wide. There were roads made 50 meters, 70 wide. Some roads are quite wide, up to 5-6 meters. I call them the main roads.
Тоже порядка 2-3 метров и даже были по 1,70 м ширина, такие же, как в Castellar de Meca. А некоторые дороги там есть совсем широкие, так называемые магистральные, до 5-6 метров шириной между двумя бортами. Расстояние между колеями, когда они попарно там находятся,
The distance between ruts on most such roads is slightly less than in Turkey. Most often it is 140-150 cm, even sometimes 175 cm. Some ruts are at a distance of 160-170 cm from each other, that is almost the entire width of the road. Consequently, vehicles with different widths between wheels drove along these roads. Widths of the wheels themselves are different. If in Turkey the width of wheels from a single drive of wheeled vehicles is 22-23 cm, then on the roads of the second type the width of the wheels varies between 8-12 cm and between 6-18 cm. That is, they are narrow wheels. Some wheels are very quite narrow, about 5-6 cm.
Шириной. То есть абсолютно разные транспортные средства, которые ездили здесь. Помимо вот этих колей, Особенно много на дорогах, вот Кастелар де Мекки, да и в Турции, среди вот этих однопрокатного проезда транспортных средств.
Along with the rats imprints of field vehicles, we saw quite a lot prints of caterpillar vehicles. In Castellar de Meca in Spain, in many places in central Italy, in Turkey, when a road was too narrow, these caterpillar vehicles apparently did not fit on the road and some part of caterpillars, 2-3 cm superposed on the lower part of both sides of the roads. Imprints of caterpillars are really clearly visible. What was it? Some roads building machinery that built these roads? Or caterpillar vehicles just went on the roads. It is difficult to understand. These roads from a ramified system of roads. In Castello de Meca in Spain, you can see how the road climbs to the top of the plateau where a rock town was located. Accordingly, it goes from it down, passes through the rock town, bends along the edge of the plateau, then passes through a narrow gorge, makes another serpentine. Further, the road begins to undergo too strong erosion. It breaks into blocks, and limestones of the road close are displaced by shifts to different sides. Pieces split off from them, roll down in a slope. Then the road is lost in the contemporary sediments. All this shows that the road is not modern. The road has a Neogen age. Overlapped by quaternary sediments broken by falls that form in the latter area, at a geologist, the Neogen age of the road cannot cause doubt. On the other side, the road in Castello de Meca goes down. It is becoming less noticeable. Begins to get lost in diluvial sediments at the foot of the slope. Then, in the place of this road, in the gorge, a deep stream begins to flow. Quaternary alluvial, possibly diluvial sediments accumulated in it. Considering that the road is the lowered part of the relief, it began to be marked by the gorge with steep slopes that water cut in the sediments. At first, it is slopes of 1 to 2 meters deep. Further, their depth reaches 5 to 6 meters. That is, the road turns into a stream in quaternary sediments.
Вначале накопились четвертичные отложения там, делювиальные, видимо, может, алювиальные отложения, склоновые, речные. А учитывая, что все-таки дорога – это пониженная часть рельефа, вот, эта пониженная часть рельефа стала маркироваться тем, что там вода пробивает поток. И эта дорога дальше превращается в ручьи достаточно с глубокими склонами. Вначале они там метр-два, а потом и 5-6 и более метров вот такой вот глубины. То есть дорога превращается, покрытая ручей в четвертичных отложений. Вот, в Крыму великолепная серпантин дорога Веске-Кермен. Она очень сильно изменена.
In the Crimea, a magnificent serpentine road can be seen in the rock town of Eskikirmen. This road underwent severe erosion, which confirms its ancient age. Rats in limestone have smooth outlines. Here, of course, can be no questions about any modern passage of vehicles, carts. It is clearly visible from above that the road passes along the edge of the rock town located on the plateau, then it goes through a short gorge, makes a serpentine, then another, and it lost in the forest. I observed the same road in Chufut-Calais in the Crimea. It has a standard profile there, with two sides, passes through the rock town located on the plateau. Then it descends the slopes in two different directions of Chufut-Calais. It also forms the serpentines of the slopes and it lost in the forest. On stone roads there are different number of ruts and different profile of the ruts, just like on modern dirt roads. If the ground was dry enough and cars drove along it, then two ruts formed, which looked several times wider than usual ruts. Their widths can be 35-40 cm, there are wide grooves on both sides. If there was a dirty, wet road, then on the contrary, narrow ruts formed on it, which deeply sank into the ground. Such ruts have different forms of left and right sides. The ruts are often not symmetrical when machine slips. On stone roads, two traces of slipping, steering, squeezing out mud are clearly visible. It is clearly seen that wheeled vehicles went at a time when the soil was wet and loose. Of course, there can be no question of any passage of carts according to archaeologists' view.
То есть это видно, что это средство ездили в то время, когда грунт был рыхлый. Да, и, конечно, ни о каком здесь проезде телег, как считают, вот как считаются археологи, быть речи не могло. Третий тип дорог, колей каменных.
The third type of stone roads and ruts is a combination of the first and second type of ruts and roads. When stationary roads, for example, in Castellar de Meca in Spain, intersect with ruts from a single passage of wheeled vehicles, we saw quite a lot of such places. Ruts are sometimes at different levels there, as if jumping one off top of another, forming ledges. The height of the ledges, of course, is insignificant. Nonetheless, they are clearly indistinguishable. Let's talk now about how archaeologists explained, or rather explained until now, the origin of stone ruts and ruts. This is a very little literature devoted to ruts, perhaps because their origin is very difficult to explain from the standpoint of academic archaeology. When it is completely impossible to distance the ruts, for example, in the Crimea, Chufut-Calais and Eski-Kirmen, or in central Italy, archaeologists usually say that they were formed from multiple passages of loaded carts over them. Carts drove and drove along the same tracks. As a result, they destroyed the hard rock, limestone and such ruts that we see were formed. I prove in a series of my works that this version doesn't stand up to any criticism. Firstly, because no matter how many loaded carts drove along the ruts and how long they went, they would not leave such a deep furrow without destroying the sides of limestone or tuff, without crushing them. Many ruts have smooth, gentle outlines, as if they pressed into plasticine. Secondly, in several places we saw the squeezing out of the mud, which was petrified. This, of course, cannot be explained in any ways by the passage of carts on hard limestone. Certainly, I have already said in the previous film about subsidence of the soil. When the sides of roads with a width of 2 meters began to shift, and the width of roads in such areas becomes less than a meter. On the roads of this width there could not be a car or a cart, nothing moving on four wheels. It is clearly seen that such alterations of the road profile occurred in a plastic state, when the ground was not yet petrified. This was based on the geology in the Neogene period. Finally, I especially spent time to check the arguments of archaeologists. I walked along the modern mountain roads in Chufut-Calais, Mangab-Calais, Eski-Kirmen, on which jeeps which carry tourists have been driving for several decades. I looked at the ruts and prints left by jeeps. That's it. In limestone, they do not leave prints at all, only traces of black rubber when breaking. They leave very shallow, the first millimeters, a maximum of up to 1 centimeter prints in calcareous crushed stone. When they go on a clay soil or the ground, then the ruts are clearly discernible. If the soil is solid, then the ruts are not so deep, the first centimeters. When it rains, the ruts go deeper by dozens of centimeters. Skidding on the mud begins, driving some of the ruts to other begins. The sides of the ruts acquire different shape. Further along, many of these ruts screams follow. We observed a similar picture both in Chufut-Calais in the Crimea and in Jumilla in Spain. When streams ran down ruts, which greatly depends them. Sometimes such streams along the ruts cut through the rock more than a meter. Sometimes the streams, on the contrary, cut the ruts. When standing stone ruts, we didn't have any single thought for a moment that such ruts could be left at any other time than the Neogene.